our next chapter. I think about all the moments on our path throughout undergrad. Late nights in Thode, 20-minute Tim's lines in the 11:59 p.m. submission. So, I'm finally here. Graduation. Hooray. I know I should be looking forward to my future, but I can't help it. I can't help but wonder, what if?
There's a line from a famous Robert Frost poem. It goes like this.
I shall be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads
diverged in a wood.
And
I took the one less traveled by.
And that made all the difference.
I wish I could say the same. If I can't change the past, I'd want to do it over. Maybe then, I'd stop it from running through my mind.
What if I had given him a chance?
What if I had stayed? What if I had chosen differently?
Elizabeth Montgomery?
Thanks.
Thank you.
start of a new chapter.
A new adventure.
New school.
New people.
I can't believe I'm really here.
It's still welcome week. School hasn't even started, and I already have so much to do. I haven't even finished unpacking yet.
Yep. This may have to wait. I need to get a head start on my classes and start looking for a lab position.
Anyway, I should probably call Ryder back. I don't want to be rude or leave him hanging. I know there's that two-day no-call rule. Is a few hours too soon?
Probably, but what am I even thinking? I cannot be getting distracted by boys this early in the semester, or at all.
But it is just one phone call. And it might not even turn into anything. And if it does, it's just one date, if I can even call it that. Maybe he just wanted to have, and I'm sorry I physically ran you over dinner.
To call or not to call? That is the question.
Oh, what the hell?
No.
I'm gonna do it. Oh, hey. It's me, Liz, from campus today. You put your number in my phone? Yeah. Anyway, if your offer still stands, would you want to go out sometime? Next Friday? Okay, great. I'll see you then. Okay, bye.
Bye.
And you're watching Macsci Minutes. I'm here with Dr. Callahan's lab group. Everybody's talking about how you're entering a big competition run by Elon Musk. Is this true? Is that why you took over the lab in the second basement of BSB?
Yes, we've entered the Esoteric Logistic Organization and Martian Universal Settlement kerfuffle. Elon Musk for short. Musk for shorter. The goal is to move towards Mars colonization.
But not because of evil Elon. I'm 97% sure he's an alien.
Excuse me?
Oh, come on. You really believe he's human? This is all just a ploy to get him home. Think about it. His son's name is proof alone that he is not, has never been, a human.
Yes, Musk is going to be the lab's main goal this year.
There are also talks around campus that Dr. Jessen's lab has also entered the competition. What do you think of that, Ava?
It's actually pronounced Ava. Ava. And they always try to join everything we do, but we're totally going to come out on top. They always come up with the stupidest team names, too.
That's true. Last year they were called 12345 or something stupid like that.
Oh, so literally the code to every single projector on campus?
Obviously they forget.
So tell me more about the work you're doing.
Don't worry, Ryder, you're a shoo-in.
Well, I hope so. I've always wanted to be part of this lab.
Well, you definitely picked the right one to interview for.
Rowan, we shouldn't say anything yet. He isn't even an official member.
Wait. What do you mean, right one?
You'll find out soon enough.
How do you think your interview went?
Good, I hope. I spent all night preparing for it.
Well, I'm sure you did great. You would be the perfect addition to our lab.
I really want to be a part of Dr. Callahan's work. It's exactly the cutting edge research I want to do.
So then, what do you think of the competition? I mean, the winners get to work and meet Elon Musk himself.
That would be amazing.
Oh, I'll see you guys later. Hey, Liz.
Oh, hey. I was just coming to meet you. So, where to?
Well, I was thinking of a nice walk through campus and then grab dinner at 1280.
Wow, big spender.
Oh, only the best for you, Liz.
I don't know if I would consider campus food the best in any scenario, but...
Oh, come on, Liz. Have you not tried their nachos or their lava cake? They're delicious. You could even say, I lava them.
No, I haven't, but I must say that puns are nacho specialty.
Right, so now who's the one with the terrible puns?
Still you. Mine was great.
Sure. So, are you ready? Let's get to know all the dumb first date small talk level bits about one another.
Sounds like a blast.
I want to know everything about you, Liz. Starting with your last name and social insurance number. I'm kidding. Totally second date question.
Well, you'd have a hard time with my last name, considering my full name is Elizabeth, not Liz.
Hey, my name isn't Ryder either. It's actually my middle name. My real name is Flynn, but nobody really calls me that or even knows that either, so...
Don't worry, your secret's safe with me.
Thanks. So, how's your first week been?
Pretty good. Just doing the usual stuff, unpacking my dorm, getting my textbooks.
Wow! The fact that you've already gotten your textbooks, even though classes haven't started yet, tells me more than enough about the student you are.
I may have been a bit ambitious. What have you been up to then?
Oh, you know, the usual. Staring at my bags, hoping they'll magically unpack themselves. And thinking about this girl I met.
Sounds very productive.
Oh, it was. Although, I did pull myself out of daydreaming long enough to interview for a lab on campus this morning.
Really? Me too.
Ah, so you're daydreaming about me too, then?
Day and night.
I could talk to you for hours, Liz.
So, where do I begin?
Been to McMaster. Never did expect that I could help Elon Musk.
Help Elon Musk.
Email was in my spam.
That would make sense.
And the cockroaches at Center have all fallen off the face of the earth.
They have? This is totally the work of the Church of Scientology. We're always suspected that they were going to get their fingers into this campus and run it into
the ground. How many times do I need to explain it? Tom Cruise has not kidnapped the Dean of Science and replaced her with an alien.
Oh, hey, you're the new hire, right? From us?
Oh, yeah, hi. My name's Elizabeth. Liz for short.
Well, it's nice to meet you, Liz for short. I'm Pippa. That's Nicola. And...
and this one sticking her finger in a test tube of acid, is Ava.
Ava. It's pronounced Ava. You can never be too careful. I have to check all the samples to make sure that the lizard people aren't secretly trying to microchip us. You know what those skinny bastards are gonna do when they get their claws off.
They're coming.
Ah, good, we're all here. Now, as you all know, we are still working on our project for the MUS competition. The experiment is progressing nicely, but we haven't won yet. Now, if we can just beat they who must not be named, we could quite literally change science forever. And who are you?
Oh, hi.
Shoulders back and project. For God's sake, project.
Yeah, I know, but I can't just...
I'll take it from her.
Hi, my name is Beth, and I'm really excited to be part of the work that you're doing here.
She's the new hire.
Ah, yes, good. Well, I have a meeting with the Dean of Science in 5 minutes to gloat about... I mean, discuss the state of our project, so I must be going. Kids, I trust that you and the others will help her get set up. Explain the rules.
Of course. As Dr. Callahan said, my name is Kit. Harvard class of 2019, which apparently means I get the lovely task of managing the undergrads. Now, if you don't have any questions, we can get started.
Actually, who is they who must not be named?
Did you not watch the interview we did for Macsci Minutes? That Faye called me, and I quote, Ava, not even Ava, like it should be, a conspiracy theorist. Can you believe that?
There is no sense getting worked up over it. You already requested to have it refilmed.
But like Callahan said, we still have to win, especially since our biggest rivals for the competition are known as the Jetson Lab.
Oh, it goes much deeper than that. In these halls, the Jetson Lab is pure and utter blasphemy, literally Voldemort.
I have a theory that they're all secretly highly intelligent fruit flies.
Just last week, they changed all of our lab measurements from metric to imperial.
And on Wednesday, they reprinted all the labels on the beakers from a professional Times New Roman to Comic Sans.
And yesterday, I saw Lila walking through BSB Field carrying a French horn. But she doesn't even play French horn.
The point is, the rivalry goes very, very far back. If you're going to work here, the number one rule is that you never speak that name in front of Dr. Callahan.
Jetson?
Shh. Don't jinx us. You never know when they might be listening.
They?
The robots!
Anyways, this lab holds everything to the highest standard. Our titrations are the palest of pigs. Our measurements are done to 5 decimal places. Now, I trust you've read the lab manual and are ready to get started?
No, you literally just handed it to me.
I did not graduate summa cum laude from Harvard for this. Now, listen closely because I'm only going to say this once.
No.
standard I'm used to yet, but that's a given.
Thank you.
Right, well, you'll need to read the lab manual from cover to cover at least 3 more times before tomorrow. We're making good progress, but time is of the essence.
Callahan is right. This experiment could be huge for us. If only we could figure out how to make it work, that'd be great for me. I mean, us.
We're really close, though. I can feel it.
All this childish sabotage certainly doesn't help. Now, you'll excuse me. I'm going to attend to some paperwork. Everybody, back to work.
Here, Beth, take over these samples for me while I stock up on some sulfuric acid.
Okay. I guess if it's okay, so they're not exactly up to par.
Don't worry about Kit. Her bark is much worse than her bite. But she is right, though. The rivalry is starting to get way out of hand.
Why do you guys hate them laugh so much?
Well, actually.
Kind of funny you ask.
We don't really know.
I hear it started between Callahan and Jetson. A long time ago.
What do you mean, Ava?
Ava. Ava. And I don't know all the details, but I heard that she who must not be named called our lab, and I quote, the Bates residence of labs.
Oh, that would make sense. I heard it in the lab as an undergrad, and it did not end well.
Huh. I always thought that it was some kind of personal vendetta.
Still, it must have been pretty bad for Dr. Callahan to still hate Dr. Jets.
Get back to work!
Here, Beth. We gotta start prepping the samples for today. I can treat the fastest way to pipette.
Dr. Callahan. Urgent lab meeting tomorrow. Not optional. I repeat, not optional. Your life is on the line. Oh, what now?
Good, you're finally here. On time, but barely.
Like how the university makes most of their decisions.
Sorry.
I do not need to emphasize how crucial it is that everything goes flawlessly for Musk. Our number one priority is to perfect our project so that we win. Now, rumor has it that they've also got something big planned. But our experiment could quite possibly be the greatest thing to ever happen to this university. No, the entire scientific field!
All aspects of the experiment need to be textbook for this to work. There is no room for error. Do you understand?
Exactly, Kit. Now, how has progress been this week?
Well, you see,
we're definitely making progress, but
we have nothing.
It seems we've hit a snag, Dr. Callahan. There's this one aspect of the experiment that we just can't figure out.
Well, we better figure it out soon or we aren't going to the competition. And I do not need to stress again how important it is that we beat that awful lab.
The E. coli aren't behaving as expected. Currently, we can't pinpoint the reason. We thought it had to do with the code, but it turned out to be fine.
We even checked it line by line this week.
And then we thought it was because the pH of our imported Martian soil was wrong, but it was actually normal.
I keep telling you guys that the problem is that Earth is actually flat. Think about it. Mars is round, then our flat soil isn't going to connect. Obviously the only correct solution.
As I was saying, I have a very important meeting with Dr. Joe Kim to discuss his daughter Monica, so I must be going. And if this isn't figured out by the end of this week, we could all say goodbye to everything like that.
Oh God, what do we do?
We're so screwed.
I still think I'm right.
Think, everyone, think! I may have gone to Harvard, but I can't do all the heavy lifting here.
I'm sure if we put our heads together, we can figure something
you
out,
You know
right?
Who have been bragging all about their experiment. They say it could change the universe. It might even be more impressive than ours, if we could get it to work. That'd be good for me. I mean, us.
Practically everyone on campus has heard of it by now,
News travels fast when you constantly brag about it on Spotted at Math. Like, yeah, we get it. But if we can't fix the experiment, they'll definitely win. We'll never get to present our work, meet Elon Musk, or go to Mars. Our chances at a research career are gonna be flushed down the drain. And if we can't get a job, then we'll have to move back home. And if we move back home, we'll be living in our parents' basement until we're 30. And it's only a matter of time, but by the time we turn 30, we're gonna have to adopt 10 emotional support cats!
Okay. Breathe, Nicola. You need to take it down like 7 notches.
It sure would be nice if we could see what they were doing. Maybe we could microchip them and track their movements. I know a guy who knows a guy who knows a guy. Great idea.
What?
Huh? Oh, come on now. I, of all people, cannot be seen spying like some common delinquent. I went to Harvard, for God's sake.
Literally. And any kind of sleuthing won't amount to anything, right? And besides, all their data is probably locked in a filing cabinet somewhere.
Wait, what? Why would they do that instead of storing it on a computer? That literally makes no sense.
You can never be too careful. You never know when someone's gonna try to hack in and steal all your data.
This definitely seems like a conspiracy theory. I mean, I get that you guys are rivals, but there's no way they would actually try to steal our data.
Nope, that's actually true. We print everything we do and delete the file. And then we print the file and keep it in this lab safe. We also have a secondary copy in a fire safe box off campus.
Wait, you're kidding, right? That just...
Nope.
I wouldn't put it past those snakes to try it.
So I say we go steal their files before they take ours.
Finally, someone who sees it my way.
You know what? I've had enough of this nonsense. Dr. Callahan did say we need to win no matter the cost.
Yeah, and I'd do anything to wipe that smug grin off of their slimy little faces.
Wait, guys, this is not a good idea. We really shouldn't be doing that. Guys!
Okay, so how are we gonna do this?
Well, I hear that they take their lunch break at exactly 2.07 p.m. sharp every day.
Guys, seriously, why aren't you listening to me? We shouldn't do this!
What are you doing?
I mean, I shouldn't, right? Isn't this, like, illegal?
This is gonna happen with or without you. What's your choice?
I mean, I obviously don't want to.
If you can't beat them, join them. And we need to be in this lab.
I just don't know. I don't think it's a good idea.
If you were me, I would.
Yeah, but I'm not you.
I have suggestions. If we use an app to scan the files instead of taking pictures or viewing them directly, it'll be way quicker and less obvious.
Actually, that's not a terrible idea.
Brilliant. We'll get in and out so quickly that god-awful lab won't even know what hit them.
All right, so here's the plan. We'll all take our lunch break at 1:56 p.m. and then we'll head home. I'm sorry. Are you trying to get us caught? Excuse me? The fake mustaches, the music? Could we be any more obvious?
But why would Kit be trying to betray us? Unless she's not Kit, and she's an alien copy of Kit set down to destroy us!
Kit, it's not too late to come back to us! You've got to come back in there! Come in there!
No, Nicola. I'm not trying to get us caught. In fact, I'm following proper break-in protocol. It's like we say all the time at Harvard. Never neglect the little things. Never skip on that extra effort. An additional few minutes, a soft word of praise or thanks, and a delivery of the very best thing. It does not matter what others think. It's of prime importance, however, what you think of you. You can never do your best, which should always be your trademark. If you are cutting corners and shirking responsibilities, you are special. Act it. Never neglect the little things.
Therefore, we will not neglect the small steps as we break into our rival's lab in order to steal their data to get ahead in our research. Understood?
Mm-hmm.
in T minus 32 minutes and 46 seconds. Considering we don't want to be here when they return, we need to scan and locate their data quickly. I suggest we put ourselves in its shoes and think, if we were their data, where would we be?
The filing cabinet labeled data, perhaps?
Yup, that would make sense. I'll go take watch.
I was expecting something better than this. This sucks.
It's literally the same as ours.
My point, exactly. Bulk barn.
What?
Bulk barn. When you buy 15 pounds of Erlenmeyer flasks at bulk barn, you get 20% off your entire purchase. I don't usually agree with our resident alien, the Dean of Science, but I do respect a good deal. It's not nearly as good as the 40% off I get on 17 pounds of dog treats, though.
Wait, but you don't even have a dog.
T-minus 17 minutes and 12 seconds till the eagle returns to the nest. Do you copy?
No copies yet. The filing cabinet is still locked.
Where did you get that? When they were building JHE, they realized they could save 15 cents per doorknob by making all the locks the same.
But how did you get the keys to the building?
Connection.
They write in green Sharpie?
And their calculations are in cursive.
That's three pages of pie charts. Who needs three whole pages?
All right, we've gone.
Wait!
The coast is clear.
Hey, Sky, how are we doing for time?
Time? It's relative, really.
Yeah, and relative to our progress, we are...
Oh, way ahead of schedule, thanks to my Virgo moon.
I don't know, it feels like we're running behind. We should...
Ryder, please, you need to calm down. My guru recommends deep breaths, a couple of sun salutations, and most importantly, blue lace agate.
Oh, okay?
Lila, there's a message from your inquiry tutor about...
Oh, yeah. Inquiry. As an act of asking for information. Not the second year course, HealthSci 2D06, inquiry number 2, Introduction to Biochemistry. The use of the word inquiry means that the message is urgent and I should probably reply right away.
That actually wasn't terrible.
What are you doing here?
Nicole, let me do the talking.
What are you doing here?
What?
We can't pay our competition a friendly visit. Venus is in retrograde tonight.
During our lunch?
I said, I'll do the talking.
During our lunch?
You see, we
Hey, look, it's you, Kim.
Why are you guys wearing fake mustaches?
Because we respect the rules of breaking and entering. Unlike you, our lab follows the proper procedure. Looks like science is not the only thing we're better at.
Oh, really? Then why are you trying to steal our data?
Excuse me?
Yeah, if you're better than us, why are you stealing from us?
Why are you stealing?
We asked you first.
I asked you second.
What kind of logic is that?
Harvard logic.
Don't you dare insult Harvard!
Okay. I think we all need to take a few steps back, both figuratively and literally. We broke into each other's labs, okay? You were caught and we confessed. That makes none of us the bigger person here, and arguing is not going to solve our problems.
Hang on. You're right.
I'm glad that your crystals could allow us to come to an agreement. Well, why don't we all start by saying at least one nice thing from somebody about the other lab? I can even go first. Sky. Oh, okay, I know. I like your shoes.
Oh, thank you.
No.
They were actually passed down to me from my great-great-grandpappy.
Well, then, in that case, I think you should keep them. They're a little big for me anyway.
All right. And while I like that idea, I think that we need something stronger than our words. And if Kit is thinking what I'm thinking...
I am.
Then I'm thinking of a more hands-on approach.
Please tell me you mean hugging it out.
Titration. No, burette.
How would that even work? Each team will have an unknown liter of weak acid, 1 liter of an unknown weak base, 2 drops of phenethylene, and 1 P1000. The team that
matches my rose quartz
first wins.
Wait. We're doing all of this for what? Bragging rights? Brownie points?
Well, my guru does say that I shouldn't spend my energy on things that don't actively reward me.
What does your guru suggest we do then, Sky?
That's a great question. I've played all my cards, and that's what you've done too. Nothing more to say, no more ace to play. The winner takes it all.
Wait a minute. Those are the lyrics to Winner Takes It All, the hit 1980s song by Swedish pop group ABBA.
Sky's guru is ABBA.
I accept.
But if we lose,
I never lose.
Three is more.
slide, right?
What do you suggest we do? This whole opportunity is ruined for me. Us.
Well, whatever the case, Dr. Callahan cannot find out what happened. This is her life's work, her magnum opus.
Well, if Liz hadn't been using the mating strategies of a tropical bird, we would have won.
What are you talking about?
You know, with that first year in the lab who shall not be named, you were so distracted. If you hadn't had your eyes on him, you would have won. So it's her fault we lost.
I'm okay with that.
Oh, wait, I was not flirting, I swear. Guys, relax. Liz would never do something like that, and that bet was a mistake. She made a mistake. Regardless, there's no way you would be friends with somebody from that lab, right?
Right. No doubt.
And you're sure about that?
Yeah.
See?
That just sounds like one of your conspiracy theories, Ava.
Ava!
Well, in any case, we have to figure out how to get our work back. If they presented the competition, they'd surely win, and we would never hear the end of it.
I have the solution. Move.
Triangle?
Exactly. Triangles are everywhere. What do we have here? McMaster canvas. Now, right here we have J-H-E. Up top we have B-S-B. Right, we have Musk. Coincidence? I don't think so. What's in the middle of this triangle? Right here? BSB field. Do you know what happens at BSB field? Alien sightings! All day, every day, every day of the year. This explains the geese. It's the Illuminati, guys! We just have to call up.
We cannot call up Tom Cruise and ask him to kidnap any more McMaster students or faculty.
So you admit that I'm right.
In any case, it's about to get a lot worse.
Good morning, everybody. I just got back from a meeting with the Dean of Science, who was very impressed by our work. She said, and I quote, if I was Elon Musk, I would buy the rights to this idea right away. Well,
you see.
The thing is, we've been trying to fix the code, but
we have absolutely nothing.
Missing a semicolon or something. Let me come have a look.
No.
Okay. No matter. I'm sure you will figure this out. Check over your work again. Do whatever it takes so that things go perfectly for Musk. We must win at any consequence. Now, if you'll excuse me, it's Tropical Bird Week on the Discovery Channel. Ta-ta! Or should I say, caw-caw? Well,
flamingos! So now what are we gonna do?
We can't just hide this from Callahan forever.
You're all right. It's my fault. My fault we have no data. My fault we're not gonna make it to the competition.
My fault I let myself get distracted. This can't be how it ends.
I need to get back in there and prove to everyone that I'm serious.
My friends have worked so hard on this project. I need to fix this.
And once I do, they'll finally realize that I can do good work too.
And we'll be back in the competition.
The research is lost. 400 hours work. We have no method. We have no data. Competition is coming, and I'm starting to think we're running out of time. We have to plan. We have to plan now.
Thank you.
Wow, you really got me with that one.
Kit!
Hello? What are they doing here? Dr. Callahan called Dr. Jets, she who must not be named, into her office. They've been talking for 13 minutes and 53 seconds now. This is Iowa all over again.
Do you know what the meeting's about?
No!
Sorry.
No, Dr. Callahan did not find it necessary to inform me.
Well, are you sure that everything's okay?
Yes!
Sorry.
Yes, everything is fine. Completely fine.
If you say so. I didn't think Kit could get any more uptight.
They must have found out. How could they have found out? We were so careful. We put away the acid and the base and the beakers and the buckets and the pipettes and the phenolphthalines. The pipette tips. A missing tip was the tip.
Ava, is it?
Ava!
Ava. Yeah, if you don't want them to find out about the lab and the vet, maybe screaming about it isn't the brightest idea.
Breathe, Ava, breathe.
You need a crystal.
And I have a perfect one, an amethyst, just for you, you angry little gremlin.
Guys, relax. There's no way that Callahan or Jetson know about the bet. Telling them would be social and scientific suicide. And even a first year would know that. Right, guys?
Yeah. Excuse me, everyone. Sorry about that. Dr. Jetson and I needed to discuss something. To say it was a shock is an understatement, but
we received a call from the Musk competition.
Was cutting me off really necessary?
You were taking too long.
As I was saying before.
How are you so calm about this?
Excuse me?
Do you care about anything?
You of all people should know the answer.
Guys, sorry I'm late! Meditation ran late. Oh, by meditation, I'm talking about the extracurricular activity I signed up for. That also has to do with meditation. It's not at all related to the second year health psych course. Health habits, attitude, and wait, what's going on?
Subplot. Excuse me. Dr. Callahan, is everything all right? Musk has sent all previous updates by email.
This was not a normal update. They called to tell us that
we're banned from the competition.
What? To contextualize Dr. Jetson's statement, Musk received an anonymous tip about how you all broke into each other's labs, stole each other's data, and then challenged each other to a bureautless titration competition where, quote unquote,
the winner takes it all?
Well, what do you all have to say for yourselves?
That's an exact retelling of events. Only someone who was there could have provided such a detailed report.
Lab rat!
Stop! It was me! I called Musk! We had no research, we had no plan, and I couldn't help but think, this is all my fault?
Plan after plan after plan. We were failing faster than a first year taking chem. There were more to go. We were only on plan 24.
One plan, then another, and then another.
But we can figure this out. We have to figure this out. We have 38 ways to figure this out. Somebody bring me those goddamn plans.
And then another, and then another, and then
we need to be better. We have to bring our best. If our science is world saving,
You lost, fair and square. If winner takes all, then why should we pay the cost?
And no way out of this mess.
And then
question. I don't know.
So, let's review. Not long ago, I made a choice, a stupid choice. No hesitating, committed the kind. A self-destructive, picked up the phone to save all our wagers. In retrospect, it wasn't smart to make a reckless decision. No one except a super desperate student with nothing to really lose would consider.
So then, of course, you called. Oh yeah, student is me. In case you were wondering, calls on us, reports the fight, and actually gets us banned. So obviously everyone is really mad. And so, and how do I say it? I fucked it up. You really fucked it up.
I got the job, I got the guy, except the holds forbidden part. And now I'm in lab with those who think I'm a calculating bitch.
And in case you forgot, I'll tell you who you really are. You're me and I fucked it up.
You really fucked it up.
By the time we graduate, nobody will remember all the shit that you put both of us through.
Consequences of our own actions.
We're trying to help. I get that. I think we all do, but you made a call that wasn't right and now we're all paying for it.
You have to talk to the lab. State your case. Explain. Do what you need to do, Beth, but talk to us.
We're a team. You and me, and whatever you decide to do, I'll be there for you.
You're not mad?
Mad?
Not at you.
I couldn't be.
Everyone makes choices.
Some are good and some are bad.
And yours definitely weren't great.
But everyone will understand why you made it eventually.
You were trying to help, and I think all anyone wants is an explanation.
Come talk to the labs, please.
Do they even want to talk to me?
Of course they do. They just want to understand and move forward. We may have lost out on the competition.
And everything that could have been. But the lab will be fine. I mean, they've been feuding for years.
And all you did was add fuel to that fire. Besides, you're my friend.
Well, girlfriend, if that's what you want. And I want you in my life, so just talk to the labs. Apologize.
Okay.
I will. I promise.
They deserve an explanation. I need to fix everything that I did.
Hopefully they won't hold a grudge forever and I can just move past this.
And hopefully they can see that what I did was to help them. I didn't mean to ruin everything.
I'll do it tomorrow at our lab meeting.
It'll be the perfect time to apologize.
That way I can figure out what the hell I can say to fix everything that I did.
God bless you, Ben. I really, really wish you the
the best, I'll tell you what. Come back to the lab, we'll hear you out. Because we're friends, but mostly because we're curious to see exactly how you'll fuck it up.
Apologize.
I'm sorry.
I'm so sorry. I couldn't do it anymore. All the cheating and scheming and lies. I guess I'm just not cut out for this. I know I shouldn't have made that call, but I did, and I'm so sorry.
There's no excuse. Well, thank you for your apology, Elizabeth. What's done is done. Kit, I will leave it to you to decide if she is to remain with the lab. Sky, I believe you and the rest of your group are free to go.
Actually, Dr. Callahan, I should resign. I mean, no disrespect to you or your work. Please know I appreciate the opportunity that you've given me, but I no longer deserve it. I screwed up, and the only thing I can do now for this lab is to leave.
Well, then it seems you've made our decision for us. I respect your accountability and wish you all the best.
Thank you.
Now, as I was saying, Sky, I believe you and the rest of Dr. Jetson's lab are free to go.
Wait, I know you're all busy.
Not anymore. But if you have 5 more minutes.
447, 448, 449.
I found a loophole.
5 more minutes.
Do you have another whiteboard?
Hey, can we talk?
I'm pretty booked for today.
Please?
Yeah, I guess I can do my laundry later.
Thanks for agreeing to talk.
Are you okay?
I'm fine.
I didn't expect you to quit.
It was the right thing to do.
You know, you don't
have... Okay, wait. I want to get this out before you say anything else. Okay, look, I'm sorry. I screwed up, and I know I shouldn't have made that call, and I shouldn't try to fix everything, and I know I said all this to the lab, but I owe you an apology, too. I don't know, something about this, us, scares me. Never done anything like this before. It's all new. And seeing you in that lab competition and working with the other side scared me, and I kind of panicked. That's part of why we lost that stupid competition, because I was distracted and, I was distracted by you. Well, by us. And I felt so bad that I let my lab down, and look, this isn't me blaming you in any way, and I promise you that, but I knew I had to choose, you or the lab. And I choose you, Ryder. I've always chosen you. And I'm so sorry I messed everything up for you and your lab and everything, and I just really hope we can make this work, because I really like you.
Okay, may I?
Yeah, sorry, I know that was a lot, I'm sorry.
Right, well, I'm not mad. I mean, not really. Yeah, it sucks we won't have the competition, but there wasn't any malicious intent behind what you did. I mean, you're a good person, Liz. And the labs will find something else to do, and we'll... I don't know.
Ryder, I know you don't owe me anything, but I like this. Us.
Liz, I don't want this to end either.
You don't?
Look, I've never really had a constant in my life. Growing up, my parents would move around a lot for work, and every 6 months or so, we'd be packing our bags and going somewhere new. Didn't really give me time to make friends or plant roots. I mean, always being the new kid. Just as I would start to get my bearings in one place, we'd be packing our bags and moving all over again. In a way, this was the first time in a long time I was living without the fear of being told to pack my things just because we're going. But having the lab taken away kind of felt a bit like that.
I'm so sorry. I didn't mean to take that away from
you. Look, it's okay. Like I said, the lab will be fine. And we'll find something else. Maybe Elon Musk will have another project for us next year. Okay?
But...
Look, Liz, things are changing, like the lab's focus, but that's life. I still have Constance, school, friends.
Us?
On one condition.
Anything.
If things are going to change, I need you to tell me about it beforehand.
I promise. All 3 a.m. mental breakdowns and calls to Elon Musk will be communicated beforehand.
Deal. Liz? I like you. I really do. This is new and... we'll probably hit bumps along the way, but we're here now, so let's just start fresh, because I think we can be really great together. I don't need you to prove all the reasons to want you. You don't need to explain, everything's understood. So don't even say sorry. You don't have to be scared that you've done wrong, 'cause you did what you thought was good. We don't need more reminders of all our lab's failures. We don't need you to get Elon Musk on our side. We're the pipettes. fears of riots and protests.
In that case, want to get some nachos and lava cake? My treat.
Right, so now who's on board with all the fancy campus food?
Not fancy, just delicious.
Deal.
Why should we trust you?
Rowan, in inquiry, our peer tutors tell us to respect all opinions.
But her last bright idea got us banned from the competition.
Rowan is right. I did get us banned from the competition.
Boo!
But we're not entirely banned from competing. Rule 314, section 15, page 926, states that a banned team cannot compete. Rule 34, section 5, subsection I, subsection B, states that teams are to be entered under a unique team name. Dr. Callahan and Dr. Jetson, at any point did Musk ask about the individual team members?
No.
No.
That's what I thought. This competition is run by Elon Musk, so they don't really care who enters, and that's our loophole. If they don't know who we are, they can't technically ban us. So all we have to do is re-enter under a new team name.
Oh my god, what a good catch.
Oh, hold up, hold up, hold up. What do you mean by we?
The loophole does allow for teams to separately re-enter, but time doesn't. It cost us 21 days of research.
21.358.
The competition is in 7 days. This is our only chance.
So you want us to team up on this short notice? There's no time to teach them our protocols, our procedures, and our lab rules.
Actually, I think lab rules only took 3 minutes and 28 seconds.
It has to be done. Sky, did you read any of our research?
Not really. My guru actually suggested that I shred it to clear my conscience, and I used the scraps to make a paper mache bra. Oh, and I may have also burned some, just for good measure.
You shredded our research?
Yeah, and burned some. Keep up, kid. I also used some sage afterwards. But don't worry, I really fixed the vibe.
Speaking of copies,
more secrets?
Like the one about you being in Heltzai?
Heltzai? That's absolutely preposterous!
I know it. A virus was within you.
Well, the truth of the matter is, I've always wanted to be in LifeSci. I've always wanted to be a real scientist, do all the cool research, and hang out with cool people like you guys. But I was rejected. Hiding who I truly was just to be in my lab and go into health sci instead. But I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Please don't reject me like your program did.
I can promise you, Lila, nobody cares.
Anyways, what were you saying, Beth?
I never deleted the copies off my phone. I didn't think about it earlier, but then I found a loophole and realized this may be our only chance. Kit, Sky, why don't you explain our projects? Exactly. Dr. Jetson's research lacked a problem, and ours lacked a solution, which is why I propose—
No! No! I cannot support the merging of our two labs!
Why not?
We're rivals for a reason. It all started with the two camp.
Pardon me. Dr. Callahan, your mother is on the phone for you.
Thank you, Kit. Tell Martha I'll return her call after this meeting.
Wait. Your mother's name's Martha?
Yes.
My mother's name's Martha.
Thank you.
Oh, I'm just waiting for Ryder. We're meeting up for dinner.
Ryder, right. I guess he's pretty not busy preparing for us tomorrow.
Yeah. Look, Pippa, I'm so sorry.
No, Liz, I'm sorry.
And the whole Ryder thing, I did not know he was in the other lab, and nothing happened until after I left, I swear.
You don't have to explain, Liz. You can be with whoever you want to be with.
Yeah, but I feel like I let everyone down.
No, Liz, really. It was a lot easier to blame you and completely cut you out of the lab, rather than admit that we all had a part to play in this. You may have lit the match, but we all helped you set the whole thing on fire. But besides, without you, we never would have found our new research competition. We're helping Jeff Bezos bring Amazon Prime to, wait for it, Mars.
Wow, 2-day shipping and everything?
You know it.
Seems like you guys have really picked yourselves up.
Yeah, and we're actually back to competing with the Jetson Lab. Somehow they entered the competition as well.
Just like old times, I guess.
Yeah, I'm surprised you didn't know, considering your boyfriend.
Yeah, we don't talk about the lab very often. It's easier that way, so.
Right. Well, it sounds like you're happy, like we both are. It looks like everything worked out for the best.
Right, happy. Guess everything happens for a reason.
Very true. Well, I'm gonna go catch up with Ava and Nicola now.
Oh, bah!
Okay, well, I'll see you around, Liz.
Yeah, see you around. Good luck with the competition.
Thanks. Hey.
Are we not still mad at her for screwing up the competition for us?
No. It's not like we're going to be BFFs anytime soon, but we still have to be nice. She did step back when she realized that she screwed up.
That is true. Just don't let her back into the lab next year. I already had to convince myself that an Elon Musk competition wasn't going to kill me. Now I have to do the same for Jeff Bezos, who, I'm sorry, is totally worse.
Well, hey, at least we're ready for this competition. Especially, because if we win this, it could be huge for us.
Not if, when?
Well, we know when. The competition is literally tomorrow.
So, are we all ready to win this thing?
Oh yeah, Musk has no chance.
Wow, the whole crew's together. What's the plan? A recent celebratory show? Does anyone know any good ones?
Ooh, the Mac Eng musical is performing Shrench from April 7th, 8th, and 9th.
We can't celebrate yet. We also have to get ready for tomorrow.
Oh, come on, Kit. The stars have projected good vibes only.
Fine.
Yes! Woo-hoo!
Hey, Beth, wait up.
Hey, what's up?
I just wanted to thank you for everything you did for the labs. I mean, bringing us together and all, that was pretty amazing. You are pretty amazing.
Thanks. I mean, I made the mess, so I did what I had to fix it. Gave up what I had to as well.
Well, either way, I think you did a great job, and I hope that we can still be friends at least.
Yeah, friends. Sounds great.
Okay, cool. Yeah, friends. Anyway, we should probably meet up with the others, right?
Probably.
Yeah. Sorry. This feels familiar.
I'm getting a little bit of deja vu.
Yeah. Anyways, we should go before Kit goes another Harvard tangent.
I'm Kit, Harvard class of 2019.
You're all imbeciles.
I had the honor of taking care of you guys.
Or Rowan offends someone with her inevitable sarcasm.
Yeah, or Ava
Remember,
it's Ava! Ava!
Right. Ava!
Very good job, sir. Very good.
Why
job.
Is it pronounced like that?
Who knows, man?
Really just happened, or have I been abducted by lizard people? The next logical step would be to wipe my memories and then replace me. Right? Right? Right?
Oh, so you don't remember giving that 15-minute impromptu lecture about the Flat Earth Society?
What?
Is that a toy car?
Yeah.
Oh. Wait, you guys, it's our feedback!
Oh my god!
Oh, wait, stop! Nobody move! I need to cleanse its energy first! Everybody, come on! Fantastic. Well, what are you waiting for? Read the results!
Allow me. Not important, don't care, blah, 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 blah. Ah, here it is. Unfortunately, you were not chosen as finalists.
That's really sad.
Give it to me. There. Ewan did say that if he ever needed a babysitter for his son, X-A-12, we would be his first choice. And then he explained the name, hold on, X, the unknown variable, Ash, my elven spelling of I, love or artificial intelligence, and A-12, the precursor to the SR-17, our favorite aircraft. No weapons, no defenses, only speed. Perfect in battle, but nonviolent.
Is that for real?
Yay! Woo!
This calls for another celebration!
I agree! Yes!
Let's do it!
Hey, Beth, are you coming with?
Yeah, sure, I'll be right there.
Well, you better be. As founder of this team, you are obligated to be there.
I don't feel like I should be.
What do you mean?
I know that it's not all about winning, I know that, but we didn't even make it past the first round. I asked you guys to trust me, and this showed that you shouldn't have, or that I should have just quit.
No. What do you think would have happened if you quit?
I don't know.
Exactly, you can't know, but you do know what happens when you didn't quit.
Like not advancing?
Exactly. Or like getting a mildly creepy compliment from Elon Musk, or mending a 28-year-long primary. Exactly. So would you quit moping and come out and celebrate with us instead of thinking about what could have been?
Fine.
Let's go.
Hey, guess what day it is today?
Musk.
Yes, but also our 1 week anniversary.
I'm sorry, I just can't stop thinking about the lab. I thought quitting was the only thing I could do. That's why I did it. But Dr. Callahan was in no rush to fire me. Kit didn't seem to be either. Is there another way I could have fixed things?
Well, was there?
I don't know, that's my whole point.
Then you couldn't have fixed things any other way.
Yeah, but what if I did know?
Look, I'm not gonna tell you it was the only way, because there were 100 ways you could have fixed things. You could have walked away, fought for a spot, or stayed and blended into the back for the rest of the year. I mean, each option has its own ebbs and flows, but you made a choice and you can't go back. So forget about it and just be here with me.
I just feel like I could be a completely different person.
It's not simple to say. Most days, I don't know who I could be. The heist, the lost bet, the call that I regret, and what if still runs through my head. It's not easy to know I'm not anything like I used to be. Although it's true, start over, for worse or for better, I still remember. She's imperfect, but she tries. She is good, but she lies. She is sure. She is falling and can't ask for help. She is quiet, but she's kind. She is lonely most of the time. She's on the edge waiting and watching as time passes by. She is gone, but she used to be mine. And it's not what I asked for. Sometimes life just slips in through the lab door and carves out a person and turns you into someone new. The road splits in two. And it's not what I asked for. If I'm honest, I know I would give it all back for a chance to start over and take the path I didn't choose. For that girl that I knew, who is eager just to learn, who gets lost, but who learns how to toughen up when she's forgotten and gets caught in the free fall of love.
Finally made it all the way through.
I spent so many hours in Thode, but I still only got nines on everything. I think it's because I'm cursed.
It took us some time, but we finally made it.
I'm just glad Ava can stop yammering my ear off about triangles this and flat earth that.
It's over. It's been 4 years. It's literally not that hard.
But why is it pronounced Ava instead of Ava?
My name is Avocado Toast, obviously.
Literally, what the...
For real, though. Like, my parents were super hippies. Check out this acceptance letter I got from Harvard.
Dear Avocado Toast, Eggs Benedict Cumberbatch, we hereby grant you acceptance into Wait. You... got into Harvard?
What, like it's hard?
So, I'm finally here. Graduation. The last 4 years weren't easy, but if I could do it all over again, maybe I wouldn't have walked away from that opportunity. Maybe I wouldn't have turned him down so quickly. Maybe I would have chosen differently. And yet, your life's not perfect. You won, but you also lost. And I wouldn't be me if I had chosen like you.
Two roads diverged in a wood, and
I took the one less traveled by, and that made all the difference. But is that really true? You choose, everything changes, and that makes all the difference.
Hey Liz, come sit with me.
Hey Beth, they're about to start giving out the diplomas. It's not online this year, so you better make the most of it.
Liz Montgomery.
Beth Montgomery.
I spend my time chasing down the past into the great unknown. Yeah. I spend my time wondering where I could have started you again. Yeah. Where will we go?
What's ahead us, who can know?
Just take a breath.
Step into your future.
You carve the paths you follow.
You live, you learn,
you love,
you learn,
you cry,
you learn,
you lose, you learn,
you bleed,
you learn,
you scream,
you learn.
Thank you.